So let's talk a little bit more about Disney, definitely another popular, widely held stock out there, but the stock has seen much better days. And it really was Disney Plus that was the driving force behind Disney's impressive stock gains in 2019. But it's Disney's parks business that's squarely in focus for investors because of the coronavirus pandemic. And it's not looking too great right now on that front for Disney.
No. And, you know, I'm a huge Disney bull and I've been a shareholder my whole life. And I love not only the parks, but the content and just Disney. And that being said, they have half their business is going great. Thank God they went direct to consumer with digital. And thank God they took over Hulu, or else they'd be in real trouble. But, the sad fact is that they make a lot of money in parks, cruise, and resorts. And I just don't see that getting back to normal till next year. And I'm hoping by next summer. And that's a hope. And so, you know, it saddens me to say that Disney's going to have to kind of struggle through the year and then hopefully get back on its feet as soon as possible. So we've moved from a buy to a hold on Disney. But I also think management's great and they have the capital and they've got this great business now that's growing way faster than what anybody thought. And Netflix is valued more than all of Disney. And so if you really look at Hulu and Disney Plus, and then all the other assets, you know, Disney is a very cheap stock right now if you think out a couple years from now. And they're going to get a great head start in streaming now.
But the parks business, like you said, it's not very clear at this time when that's going to improve. So what signs do you think investors should be looking at? You're saying it may not be till next summer. So right. Is this a type of business that we could be, you know, waiting for a vaccine for things to meaningfully improve, even though parks are expected to reopen at least a little bit this summer?
Yeah, you know, this is so hard for me because I consider myself a fun person and I love going out. I'm in the music business too, and seeing all my musician friends and myself idled for who knows how long. And these, even for small venues, are struggling with the idea of having 20 or 30 people. So imagine trying to run a venue with 20,000 people a day and 10,000 employees.
Yeah.
It's impossible for people not to get coronavirus in that environment. So I think that we're going to be dealing this for some time to come. And large gatherings and things like Disneyland are going to be real tough to have open and safe, despite, I think, the demand for it. When especially people have not been, you know, covering, you know, using masks and using common sense in their behavior. So we're going through a stage now in America that I think is in entertainment, or whether it's shopping or anything else, is that we're all going to be using digital solutions from the workplace to everything else for the time being. And then when things get better, I think a lot of these things are going to continue.